Good morning all of you. Hope all of you are staying safe there. So in this video lecture we are going to discuss about the unit 4, that is inline theory. Outline of the presentation includes why to study inline theory and what is inline and what exactly this inline theory talks about. This inline theory is an ultimate load analysis method used for RCC's lab or a plate. This inline theory is useful to find the ultimate moment or a collapse load in the structure. So this inline means, what is inline mean? So the inline is the band of extensive cracks developed in RCC slab across which the tension steel has got yield. So let us take this two-way slab which is simply supported and which has uniformly which is loaded with a UDL condition. So here in this two-way slab, so generally in a structure the maximum moment occurs at the center of the span. So the same way here also the maximum moment occurs, maybe for a simply supported UDL condition we have the maximum moment as WL squared by 8. So that occurs at the center of this slab. So that's where this cracks start to develop first. So as the maximum the moment happens at the center of the slab, so the cracks start to form at the center, and slowly it propagates. It start forming at the center, and slowly it propagates towards the boundary. So this yield line finally it ends at the boundary of this slab. So other way we can define the yield line is, yield line is an idealization of a band of extensive cracks across which this tension steel has yielded. So let us see how this failure happens in the RCC structure. So to demonstrate this, we are considering two-way RCC slab with a simply supported condition with a uniformly distributed load. So we are taking a section along AA here, and if you see the section here, so when you are applying a UDL load, when you are applying a load on the structure, so with the increasing load, the stress level or the stress in the material also or the structure also will increase. Okay, so as you all know the concept of the stress strain curve. Okay, so when as long as it is in the elastic stage, when you are applying the load and removing the load, it behaves like elastically. So but once it crosses this elastic limit, so that with the further with the additional increase of the load, with the increasing load further, so the material will reach its yield stress stage. Okay, so even after that, if you increase the load in the structure, so there will be the permanent deformation will happen in the structure. Okay, the permanent deformation start to occur in the structure. Here the permanent deformation is nothing but the cracks that develops in the structure, because the crack develops because of the poor tensile that is because the concrete, the stress that is exceeded the flexural capacity of the concrete, so it start to develop the crack. So slowly also the material that is a yield stress of the steel also also reached. So with a further increase in the load, so there will be permanent deformation. So that's how the failure is happening in the RCC slab.